LifePointChurch.com. So glad that you're with us today. And this is the last day of our sermon series on heaven. Now, what's so great about it? But this one's a little different. It's how can we have heaven right now? Now, of course, many of the things we really can't have right now. But we can start living like that's where we're going right now. And some of the great things about heaven can start being evidenced in the life of a believer, even down here on earth. And how can we help to make that happen? That's what we're going to be talking about today. Let's go ahead and open in prayer. Heavenly Father, we love you, and we need heaven right now. We know that we're waiting patiently for it, but we want to start seeing the touches of it right now. We need more presence of you. We want to see the joy with each other. God, we want to start seeing some of the beauty and wonder of heaven as we're down here on earth. And that's part of what Jesus has promised us, God. And we thank you, the dearly God, who already delivers right now. In Jesus' name, amen. Our opening song today is by Stephen Curtis Chapman. It's called Heaven in the Real World, and that's exactly what we're talking about today, is how do we get heaven right down here, right now. I'll see you right after the song.
I saw it again today in the face of a little child, looking through eyes of fear and uncertainty. In a cry for freedom across the street and across the miles, cries from the heart to find the missing part. Where is the hope? Where is the peace that will make this life complete? For every man, woman, boy, and girl looking for heaven in the real world.
One verse of scripture today is John chapter 10, verse 10. Jesus said, "The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I came that they may have life and have it abundantly." Jesus wants us to have abundant life, not only in heaven, but right now. He wants our life to be full of meaning and purpose and joy right now. He wants you to live a very important life now, not only in heaven. See, many of the things that we talked about in heaven earlier in the week, we can start experiencing some of right now. The first thing that we said was great about heaven is that we are with God. But we know that we are with God right now as His children. Not at the same depth. I understand that. But remember, the apostles looked at Jesus and they said, "Let us see the Father." And He looked right back at him and said, "If you've seen me, you've seen the Father." We know that Jesus lives in our hearts. We have songs that say that. That the Holy Spirit abides in us. We can know God right now. One of the greatest things about heaven is being with God, and we can be with God right now. That is getting heaven in the real world, is saying, I can spend time with God right now. I can go to my knees in prayer practically to do that. I can read His Word and know Him right now. I can meditate on the wonder and glory and goodness and salvation of my Father. I can do all of this right now. One of the other things that we said are great about heaven, though, is that we can be with the people that know Christ, that we know and love. Again, right now, that's church. As we mentioned on Tuesday, church can be a struggle right now. It can be difficult. But there can also be a wonderful joy to it of saying, I get to spend time with others who know God. And I get to enjoy them. And as iron sharpens iron, so one man sharpens another. And I can be with these other people. And we can lift each other up. And we can pray for each other. And these are practical things that we can do right now to bring that joy of heaven, of spending eternity with others. One of the things that I said that I really love about heaven is thinking about not only with the family and friends that are there, but with some of the great people who've left behind and went there. But you can read about them, so many of them. There are so many who put their words in the scriptures or wrote books or left songs or whatever it may be for us that we can sort of get to know the people now. So that as we know them forever, we can get that joy of it being brought down right now. And some of those people were the worshipers. And they've left behind such great worship music and songs and art and stories and the people that we think, you know, I so want to know them on the other side. You know, we can worship God now. There are so many ways of doing that. You know what the great thing about private worship is? You can pick whatever you want. See, I pick the songs for this, trying to guess what we all might like. The guys that lead the worship at church sort of get to pick the things. But the great thing about private worship is you know what you like. Take the time to worship God now. Fill your house with beauty. Plant a garden. Do some things right now that let you experience the lovely and the noble and the beautiful so that you can think on these things and give God the glory and worship in ways that mean the most to you. Why? Because it is private worship. You don't have to include the rest of us. It's just you and God. What a great time that can be. And we also could right now start having freedom from many of the things that drag us down. We can start saying, how does a young man keep his way pure? By living thereto according to every word of God. We can start putting the word of God in us and start saying, God, keep me from sin. God, keep me from evil. Deliver me not into temptation, but deliver me from evil, God. And we can start seeing some of that freedom that we'll have perfectly in heaven delivered to us little by little here as we grow in Christ. So you say, how do we bring heaven down into the real world? Well, it's these things that little by little start showing us the joy of heaven and preparing us right now for later. And I think that brings the joy of heaven into our lives right now. Let's close in prayer. Heavenly Father, we're here today. We say, God, bring this to be true in our life. Bless us with this. Let us start experiencing some touches of heaven right now. And God, thank you that we can. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Our closing song today is Victory in Jesus. You can get some of this right now. You can get the victory right now in Jesus' name. Thanks for worshiping with us this week. Hope you have a wonderful weekend, and I want to see you again on Monday with our new theme. Have a great day.
Like me. precious blood to Tony. Then I repented of my sins and won the victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and bought me with His redeeming blood. My broken spirit, and somehow Jesus came and brought to me the victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and bought me with His redeeming blood.
He plunged me to victory.